got Baratza. Kira Kennedy, I talked to her. She's the owner, one of the co-owners of Baratza before I started this. And Kira had given me a whole bunch of information about the Baratza grinders. I'm gonna make sure all my stuff on the website's updated. But to get a good cup of coffee, number one, you gotta start with good coffee. And then I have no control over your water, but you gotta have some good water. I'm lucky here, my well water tastes awesome. It's a little hard, but I got some really great taste in water. So then I get, you know, I have the water controlled, but then the next thing that comes into play for getting your cup of coffee, the best cup of coffee, is a grinder. Most people, they'll start out with a little whirly bird grinder like this. It's just, you know, the blade on the inside, and it just chops. It's more a chopper than a grinder, and it doesn't really get you a good even grind. It's just not, it can't. And we're going to try to illustrate that a little bit tonight here with the grinders, and I was going to do it right exact and the same amount of coffee and everything here. One more variable out of it. So we're going to put 1, 2, 3 scoops in and see what we get. Well, it shook it a little bit, and it kind of sounds like it's about right. It ain't too bad. But we'll get some close-ups of this a little later. And when I started out drinking coffee, before I got into the coffee industry, I thought that was a great way to grind coffee. It's cheap, and it is. It's better than buying ground coffee at the grocery store, but you feel it, and I got chunks in here. I get some that are, I mean, there's a half of a bean. But, you know, but some of it's at the right coarse, right thickness. I'll get this Baratza grinder. We'll put another 3 scoops the coffee in that, just to have the exact same standards. Log on, people. It's nice to see somebody coming. Just a little bit about the Baratza versus, and it's actually I want to do this web show about a burr grinders in general, you know, compared to blade grinders. Because there's no comparison. And on that one, I'm just going to leave it where I had set up in the house. But I ground for Chemex Brewing. So when you get a grinder, now I wish the webcam, there's no way that you can see the difference in that. It's going to look the same, but that is going to be the first thing that's going to make a difference in how good a cup of coffee you're brewing. You got to get the grinder to the right, got to get the coffee ground to the proper coarseness, particle size. I don't want to get in the technical stuff of it because I'm not trying to do this for people that own espresso shops or, you know, I'm doing this for the average home user that, you know, likes coffee. And, you know, there's chunks in here. If I hold it still enough, you could probably see it. I can pull some away. I mean, some of it's the right size, where you look at what the Baratza did with this grind, and they're almost identical. Every single one of them are the same size. That's one of the keys to extract the maximum flavor that you can out of the coffee, is getting every single particle the same size. So you're going to extract the same coffee out of every single piece of every particle. Where this one, you got some chunks, same amount of coffee, but some are chunks and some are little tiny ones, some are ground so fine that it's going to get you bitter. Well, Heidi, that's an opinion, so whatever. I see you're not on there now anyway, so. Yeah, it's just a little informal talk to the roaster. If anybody had questions, you know, that's what I was doing it for. And I want to get a close-up a little later. I'm going to edit this to get a close-up of the with the flip video, and I might go grab it now.
You can get a real good idea. You can see the big pieces and chunks and the one that was ground in the Whirligig grinder, and how even they all are on the Baratza grinder.
The webcam is just to show what I was doing with for the YouTube channel. It isn't exactly I wanted to get some questions back. Well, the Chemex, I use it's actually a fairly coarse grind, but it's not on the, it's just past halfways to on the Maestro grinder. It's fairly fine, but it's not real fine. And that's just a personal preference, where you can, it's just a crank of the top of the Baratza and you can change the settings. We can go over to on this one. And you can get it nice and coarse. We'll just do a scoop. All the way to the taking it off. That's how you get the hopper off. But now this one is even, gets a little uneven, but it's a lot better, you know, than the, they're really coarse. Now that's what I'd use for a cowboy coffee. That's even too coarse for a French press. So, you know, I'm not going to get into the real details of it. So, just kind of an in general thing about a grinder, you know. And if this is all you got, that's great. Use it, you know. But if you're thinking about upgrading and you want a sure bet to make a better cup of coffee, it's upgrading to a burr grinder. And there's other burr grinders. This is a conical burr grinder. When you take the top off, there's part of the burrs right here. The cone part's down here, and then there's another set that's on top of it that does the grinding. They got little marks in here to line everything up, put it back in. It's easy to take apart and do maintenance on it to clean it. They sell grind. Ernex makes a product to clean grinders with that works really good too, called Grinds. And they got another one, all Full Circle or something like that, but I haven't. Looked into carrying that. Magic Bullet would work. It won't do as good of a job, but it would sure work. I mean, we got Magic Bullet type grinder in our shelf. We grind Parmesan cheese with it, and that works pretty good.
Um,
if you can brew a coffee hot when I'm cupping them, for the question to what is this, if it's hot or if it's cold, they'll taste different all through the cupping session. If I'm doing it, I'll right away when they're still hot, and then, you know, 5 minutes later, and sometimes I forget them because I'm going around doing other stuff in here, cupping coffee, and I'll do a, you know, it's completely cold, and then if they still taste good, I know I've done my job right. When they're cold, then it's been roasted right, and it's a good quality coffee. If you got something that was roasted a little wrong, and once it gets cold, it might taste bitter or even sour. It's kind of fun down here. I'm going to go till I was going to try to, you know, babble on for about 30 minutes, and I figure I could edit that down into 10 or 15 minutes of comprehensible stuff to put on YouTube. I might get into brewing something with a Chemex. Just to tie another one in, you know, here we go. Talk a little bit about the different Baratza grinders. Let me find the paperwork. I got Kira from Baratza. We have, Kira's nice enough, she drop ships for us. We don't have a real large, we don't have any working capital, really. We're just a mom and pop business, and I got, you know, my line of credit is pretty much stuck into coffee beans all the time. So I don't have a lot of extra cash laying around where I can order, you know, 50 or 100 or 200 grinders to have around. I probably only order 30 or 40 a year, and she ships them for us. But she told us I don't know. We've been dealing with them for a lot of years, and I've dropped through the economic slowdown. I've dropped a lot of companies that I don't deal with anymore just because they weren't profitable. Had callbacks, had problems with the equipment, and I quit carrying them. Baratza has always come through as a great grinder. There was one little problem they had. Oh golly, I bet you that was 4 years ago with a Maestro Plus, and that got straightened out real fast. Everybody was happy, and they took care of everybody. A change. This is the Maestro. They're making a Maestro Plus now. They're dropping the Maestro, but the Maestro and the Maestro Plus have the same burrs, same grinder, same everything as each other. The only difference was the Maestro Plus had a heavier bottom, heavier base, so when you put it on a counter, it would stay put, and it had an on-off button up here for if you took to grind right into a portafilter. This grinder, it really never ground fine enough for espresso. It would get close. If you were using a pressurized portafilter, it would work okay, but that was about it. So they decided to not, you know, to whittle down their line of grinders. They combined the Maestro and the Maestro Plus. Now the Maestro is going to sell for $149. Maestro Plus will be $149. But they sell them out before they get into the country, and they have containers coming every 2 weeks. But the Maestro, you can find it if you can find it on Amazon or eBay or any place like that. Buy it. You know, they're worth every penny. Because you can get them for $100 and you might be able to pick them up on eBay. Somebody that really didn't want it, somebody, you know, as a gift or something, you might be able to get one for you know, $40-$50. They're worth every penny. I was talking with Kira, and they had their equipment evaluated by a lot of different professionals in the industry, in the coffee industry. And every one of them agreed that the Maestro and Maestro Plus burrs and grinders were the absolute definitive best grinder for pour over coffee bars. And that's a Chemex or a, you know, a French, some people are French press bars, you know, coffee bar. They got Hario's, you build a little stand, put the cup on top, put your mug underneath what you're gonna brew into and the filter, and you pour water over it. And these grinders are the absolute best for them because you can grind for each customer. You know, you could have a pre-measured amount for whatever size you were brewing, and that's what they recommend. And that's what I'm kind of keying towards for my customers, and I think the majority of my customers are just regular home coffee drinkers that drink it at home. And, so the Maestro is just perfect. It won't grind for an espresso machine. I mean, I cannot set that to grind fine enough to brew proper espresso out of my machine. I've got a big commercial model over there, and I use a bun, and that just barely grinds. I thought about going over to my bun and getting a sample of between the two of them, between the blade grinder and the burr grinder, and see what happens, but decided to just forego that, ramble on a little bit when I talked with Kira. But the Maestro Pluses, they won't have any. It's going to be about a month before I can get any. Preciso is in stock. The the Virtuoso, the Preciso, and the Vario are all in stock. Because now it's February 22nd, so they're all in stock. And I can get them. But they don't have any of the Maestro or Maestro Pluses. They'll be in a couple of weeks, so that's, get the furnace to shut off, and it's a little quieter in here too, isn't it? Baristas and a baristos. I don't know. I think everybody's a barista. That's just a person behind the bar. Baristo? Could be. I don't know. I've always been more of a person that I brewed my coffee at home. I've always been kind of frugal, and I just always brewed it at home. We had an espresso machine. I had French presses. When I started this, I started using a Chemex, and I never went back. Right when we started the coffee business, a friend of mine had a Chemex, and let me go grab a Chemex. Yeah, maybe next week's video, I'll do something brewing in a Chemex and a French press. We'll brew something. I'm not going to get the blade grinder out again. I don't even take that when I go camping. I grind as, just what I need when I go camping, and that's what I do. I sacrifice the grind. The freshness of the grind for it's the ease, because I got electricity where we go camping now, but I just don't, dead brew is good, and that's what I do. I mean, it's better than nothing, and you can, if the French press, it works okay, and drip, auto drip, you can do pretty good, but I'm kind of picky with my Chemex. I like that to be a nice, even grind to do it well. I think I got enough there that I'll be able to edit something out of that to put it onto a YouTube channel about the Baratza grinders. I can upload things that are longer than 15 minutes now. I don't know if I want to sit and do that, but I'm going to try to do something on a weekly basis, so we'll see what happens. I can show you some tricks how to speed up a Chemex, so a little lift and lift, burp, turn, and set down again, that helps, and then stirring helps too. You can do a few things there to speed up a Chemex, and it still gets a good cup. Yeah, I drink espresso in the morning, out of a super automatic Seiko, so I'm too lazy. All I gotta do is push a button when I wake up. It's kind of funny. I had a bunch of people show up a little after 7 there, didn't we, Jim? And then they all went away. They only stick around for 5 seconds and they go. I can't type anyway. Yeah, it's I don't know, it's tough. I can get them here, but then I'm not a fancy live big show and they don't want to stay. But yeah, I can get some questions. I'm going to try it again. Promote it a little more. Get this YouTube video uploaded to my... Oh, that's what I got to do. I got to go... No, I got that close up, didn't I? Yeah. I guess maybe I need guests or something. Oh well. Yeah. Oh, they did a review of my bags? Oh, there, I've seen reviews of the Clean Calf. I've seen you find a few of them. Coupon sites, I'm all over them. You know, I don't know how the coupon sites get their coupon codes. People, they get people to give them to them? I don't know. But I had coupon codes that were expired and old, and they were getting mad. They said, well, it's published on your website. And I said, yeah, but that wasn't my website. I don't need my coupon code anymore. But, yeah, dump this back here for the vacuum. All right, I gotta get to bed. I got a lot to roast tomorrow. I got pretty close to 300 pounds to roast tomorrow.